So, welcome everyone to the presentation for the paper utilizing dependencies to obtain subsets of reachable sets. And yeah, first of all, some motivation why this topic is important. So, reachability analysis has become one of the most important methods for the formal verification of dynamical systems. However, there's one small downside, and that is that reachability analysis is often too slow to be real-time capable. So it can't be applied to verify systems in an online fashion, at least for high dimensional systems. And yeah, that's where our paper tries to contribute. So we propose a new method to reuse results from previous computation, which can help to significantly speed up reachability analysis, so that it will be applicable to a lot of also online for a lot of applications. So the general principle of our method is quite simple. So consider we have computed a reachable set for some initial set x0, and we now have some subset of the initial set x0 hat, and we want to know what is the reachable set for this subset x0 hat. Now, of course, we could execute reachability analysis again to compute the reachable set for the subset. However, that's quite costly, and we already have the information from the reachable set for the bigger set x0. And what we propose in our paper is a new method to directly extract the reachable set for the subset x0 from the previously computed reachable set for the bigger set x0. And this extraction is basically just an evaluation of analytical expressions, so it's very fast, and of course much faster than if we have to recompute the whole reachable set for the subset. Our method works for non-linear continuous systems, and since every linear system is also a non-linear system, it could also be applied to linear systems. To explain how the method works, I have to introduce two theoretical concepts. The first concept, these concepts are parameterization and dependency preservation. And we start with parameterization. And I'm going to explain this on the example of the vertex and the half-space representation of polytopes. So for the vertex representation, the polytope is described as a convex hull as of the vertices. Therefore, each point inside the polytope can be represented as a linear combination of the vertices. And as you can see, this is in the definition described with these factors delta, which are basically the factors of the linear combination. And as an example here, consider we have the point -1 and 1 that's located inside this polytope. Then we can represent it as a linear combination of the vertices and get the factors delta of 0.56, 0.2 equals to 0.1, and delta 3 equals to 0.34. And therefore, because we can each point inside the set equally represent by these factors or with these factors for the linear combination of the vertices, we say that the vertex representation is parameterized, where the parameters are basically these deltas, so the factors of the linear combination. Another representation of polytopes is a half-space representation, where the polytope is described as the intersection of multiple half spaces. In this case, we don't have parameters delta for linear combination or something similar, we just have inequality constraints, and therefore we have no parameterization here. So we say that the half space representation of polytopes is not parameterized. So to summarize, every time we have some parameters from a linear combination or something like that for the set representation, we say it's parameterized. If we don't have it and the states are given in an implicit manner, like it is the case for the half-space representation, then we don't say the set representation is not parameterized. The second concept I want to introduce is dependency preservation of set operations. So, again, I'm going to explain this with an example. So let's consider again this one-dimensional polytope here in vertex representation. And let's consider a point, the point 2, which is located inside the polytope. Then, as we have seen previously, we can, since the vertex representation is parameterized, we can express the point with these factors for the linear combination of the vertices and get delta 1 equals 1/4 and delta 3 equals 0.75. Okay, so now we consider different set operations. So the set operation we consider first is a linear transformation. Let's consider we apply the linear transformation, so the multiplication with a matrix, to the polytope. And afterwards, we still have this factors delta in there. And now if you now insert the values for this factors delta that correspond to the point P, then we get the exact same result, which is 4, than if we would apply the linear transformation to the point itself. So again, we can first compute the operation on the set, then insert the parameter values that correspond to the point inside the set, and get the exact same result as if we would have applied the operation to the point itself. And if this is the case, then we say that the set operation is dependency preserving. As next example, we consider the quadratic map. So again, if we apply the quadratic map to the polytope, and then we get this polytope shown here. And if we then insert the parameter values delta that correspond to our point P, then we get 13.5. And that's obviously not the same as if we would have applied the quadratic map to the point, which gives us 8. And therefore we say, since this is not the same, we say that set operation is not dependence preserving. Of course, what we want to have to extract this reachable subset is a dependency preserving set operations, because then we can apply a number of set operations. And if you want to know what is the result for one single point inside the initial set, we can just insert this parameter values that correspond to the point and get the same result as if we would have applied this sequence of set operations to the point itself. So far for the theory. So this table shows an overview of which set representations are parameterized and which set operations on them are dependency preserving. So we see parameterized set representations are sonotopes, where we have these factors alpha, polytopes, as we have seen, ellipsoids, also star sets and Taylor models and polynomial sonotopes. And the set operations that we use in our paper are the linear transformation, the Minkowski sum, the Cartesian product, and the quadratic map. And we see that for these set operations, sonotopes, Taylor models, and polynomial sonotopes are dependency preserving. This would be candidate sets that we could use for our reachability algorithms. In our case, we choose to use polynomial sonotopes because they have some other nice properties. And since I think polynomial sonotopes are not that common, I first want to introduce the set operation. So I think sonotopes are quite commonly known. So for sonotopes, we have these generator vectors that are depicted in black here. And each of these generator vectors is multiplied with some factor alpha that is between minus 1 and 1. So we basically get for each generator some line segment. And the sonotope itself is then basically the Minkowski sum of these line segments. And what one gets is some convex set, which is a sonotope. Now, polynomial sonotopes extend this concept to represent non-convex sets. They do this by also considering polynomial terms after the generators. So for the sonotope, each generator was multiplied with one factor, and yes, the factor for all, each generator was different. Now for polynomial sonotopes, we can have common factors, and we also can have polynomial terms of these factors after the generators. So for example, this term here, alpha 1, the cube of alpha 1 times alpha 2. And yeah, this concept allows, so we have the same generators as for the sonotopes, for the example here. But yeah, this is polynomial terms for the factors. We get a completely different set. And what is important is that the set is also non-convex. So polynomial sonotopes can represent non-convex sets. And that makes them a good choice for reachability analysis of nonlinear systems, since yeah, the reachable sets of nonlinear systems are also usually non-convex. Okay, so yeah, that was really the last part of the theory. Now, how does our approach work to extract the reachable subsets? So we have seen, we use a parameterized set representation, polynomial sonotopes, and all set operations that we need for reachability are dependency preserving for polynomial sonotopes. And therefore, also the composition of these set operations is dependency preserving. So if we execute multiple or apply multiple set operations after each other, and all these separations are dependency preserving, then also the composition of them is dependency preserving. And therefore, since our reachability algorithm is just a composition of dependency preserving set operations, then we know, okay, also our reachability algorithm as a whole is dependency preserving, and this allows us to extract reachable subsets if we just insert compute the parameter values of a point from the initial set and insert them into the result from reachability analysis. How this exactly is done, I want to again demonstrate with some example. So consider we have the initial set here, and consider the reachable set is given with this polynomial sonotope. And now we want to know what is the reachable set for a modified initial system as initial set, which is a subset of the original one. So we get the modified initial set by just setting this factor alpha equals 1, while it was between minus 1 and 1 in the original initial set. So all we now have to do to compute the reachable subset is to also substitute alpha 1 by 1 in the final reachable set. So you see, all we have to do to extract the reachable subset is this very simple substitution, which can be implemented very efficiently. So we can extract the reachable subset very fast with our new approach. This was the theory, the explanation how our approach works. Now, of course, we also did some numerical experiments. For this, we implemented our approach in the Cora toolbox, and also our implementation, as well as all examples we present here, will be publicly available with the next release of the Cora toolbox, which will be in June 2020. And all experiments for our approach were carried out in MATLAB on a 2.9 GHz quad-core i7 processor with 32 GB memory. Okay, so now in particular, I want to demonstrate on three different applications that our approach can lead to significant speedups. These applications are falsification, optimization over reachable set, and safe control. So here's already an overview where we compare the solution with our new approach with the previous solution, where we used for falsification the Estaliro toolbox as a previous solution, and for optimization over reachable sets MATLAB's FMinCon algorithm. And we see that for all these applications, our new approach results in significant speedups. And now go into detail about the applications. So the first application is falsification. In falsification, one has some specification that defines some forbidden set, which is shown in red here. And the goal is to find an initial state inside the initial set and some input signal that leads to a trajectory that enters this forbidden set and therefore falsifies the system. Now, with our approach, we have seen that we have this kind of analytical relation between this initial states and the reachable states. And yeah, we can exploit this to efficiently determine the most critical initial point. So the point inside the initial set that violates the specification the most, by just solving an optimization problem that exploits this analytical relation. And with this, we see that we get, for this two-day example already, we are faster than S0. We also considered a more high-dimensional system, which is this quadrocopter benchmark, which is 12-dimensional. And yeah, for this benchmark, you see that our approach was not really much faster, much slower than for the two-dimensional case, while S0 needed much longer. And the reason is that S0 is sampling-based, and for sampling-based algorithms, of course, they suffer from the curse of dimensionality. So for high-dimensional systems, they usually get quite slow. And with our approach, as we have seen, scales very well to high-dimensional systems. The second application we consider is optimization over reachable sets. So again, we consider we have some specification and we want to scale the initial set in such a way that the final reachable set does not intersect of the specification or the forbidden region anymore. In the previous solution, one had to use nonlinear programming to solve this, and in each evaluation of the cost function and the constraint function of the nonlinear program, one would have to compute the reachable set again and again. And of course, this is very costly because the cost and constraint function has to be evaluated very often. With our approach, however, we can again exploit this analytical relation between the initial states and the reachable states. And therefore, we are able to find a solution much faster, as we can see in the table. So with our approach, our approach takes only 0.13 seconds, while MATLAB SolveMinCon needs 172 seconds to find a good solution. The last application I want to show is motion primitive based control. So in this, for motion primitive based control, one computes the reachable sets and corresponding controllers offline for a lot of different motion primitives. And online, then these motion primitives are concatenated to solve some control task with dynamical obstacles. Now with our approach, so it is a case that in order to concatenate these motion primitives, one considers for the offline application a whole set of initial states. However, during an online application, we get one measurement. So we only have one point where we are. And now we can use our approach to extract the reachable subset for this single point inside the initial set. And what we get is a much smaller initial reachable set, and that greatly reduces the conservatism. So we might be able to, with this smaller reachable set, be able to solve control tasks that we couldn't have solved with the original reachable set. Okay, some short summary what we have shown. So we presented a novel method for the extraction of reachable subsets for nonlinear continuous systems. We have demonstrated on three applications, which were falsification, optimization over reachable sets, and motion primitive based control, that this new method results in significant speedups. And of course, these three applications are not the only three that our method is useful for, but we just couldn't show a limited amount of applications in our paper. But there might be a lot of other applications too. And finally, our approach scales very well with the system dimensions, and it's only has quadratic complexity with respect to the system dimension. And yeah, Cepheid is also well suited for high dimensional systems, as we demonstrated with this falsification of this 12 dimensional quadrocopter benchmark. So thank you very much for your attention, and I'm looking forward to your questions.